My dear students, today I am going to discuss about diagnostic agents. In this chapter, we will read about its definition, classification, and physical and chemical properties, storage condition, chemical incompatibility, and uses of the drugs as per the syllabus. Very first question arises, what are the diagnostic agents? So, diagnostic agents are the chemicals, substances that are used to detect abnormalities in tissue and organs, or they are used to test organ function. So thus, these are the useful in clinical diagnosis of the disease. Here, I would like to remind one point that diagnostic agents are not possess any medicinal and pharmacological effect. Means, they do not have any medicinal and pharmacological effect. Here, I would explain it with the help of an example. Suppose we take aspirin, and aspirin lowers the fever. So, aspirin is having its therapeutic effect. But on the other hand, if you are using any diagnostic agent, say for example, Comared or Evans Blue, so they will not show any therapeutic effect. Here, the example is the X-ray film are used for the radio. As far as the classification of diagnostic agents are concerned, they are classified into types. First is radio opaque, that is also known as X-ray contrast media, and there also second one is agents used to test organ functions. Radio opaque or X-ray contrast media are again of two types. First is water soluble contrast media, and second is the water insoluble contrast media. The example of water soluble contrast media is phosphate or citrate buffer. Similarly, the example of water insoluble contrast media is propylidone and ipanoic acid. Agents that are used to test organ functions, mainly they are used to test kidney function. For example, indigo tin sulfonate, that is also known as indigo carmine, to test liver function. For example, sulfobromethylene sodium, and some are miscellaneous. For example, fluorescent sodium, Evans blue, and the Congo red. Diagnostic agents can also be classified on the basis of organ, like if they are used for the blood vessels, the process is called angiography. For joints, this is called arthrography. Bronchography is used for the lungs. Cholangiography is used for the gallbladder and the bile duct. Hepatography for the liver. Lymphography for lymph nodes and the vessels. Myelography for brain and the spinal cord. Pyelography for kidney and the ureter. Splenohepatography for the liver and the spleen. Urography for the urinary tract. Radio opaque agents have an ability to absorb X-rays, that is, they are opaque to the X-ray radiation, and this is the property of X-ray radiations or these radio opaque agents, that they are able to produce lighter or whiter shadow on the X-ray film. For this purpose, In 1924, iodine was used. Here, I would like to mention that both organic as well as inorganic forms of iodine were used, but inorganic form were discontinued as it ionized to give the toxic compounds. So, iodinated organic compounds are used because they are less toxic. Now, if we talk about its administration, organic iodine compound can be administered by two ways. First, a systemic procedure, or secondly, by the retrograde procedure. In systemic procedure, they are administered either orally or through intravenous route. In retrograde procedure, agents are introduced by the mechanical means. If they are introduced systematically, they are used for urography, cholecystography, Roentgenography. By retrograde procedure, the radioactive compounds are introduced by catheter into urinary tract as discussed earlier. Radioopaque contrast media are of two types. First one is water soluble contrast media, and second one is the water insoluble contrast media. As far as water soluble contrast media are concerned, pharmaceutical buffers, phosphate or citrate buffers, and sesquiterine agent are water soluble contrast media. They are mainly used for urography, that is examination of ureter, kidney, and angiography. All of you must know what is angiography. So angiography is the examination of the arterial system. Water insoluble contrast media are the agents that are practically insoluble. Please remind it, they are practically insoluble in water, and hence their suspension are prepared. For example, propylidone and iopinoic acid. Mainly they are used for cholecystography, that is examination of liver and gallbladder, and they are also used for bronchiography, that is the examination of the bronchial pathway. In our syllabus, seven compounds are mentioned that we are supposed to read. So let's recall them: iopinoic acid, propylidone, sulfur bromoethylene sodium, indigotin disulfonate, that is also known as indigo carmine, immense blue, congo red, and the fluorescent sodium. So my dear students, before proceeding further, so all of you must know the names of all these seven compounds. Iopinoic acid contains three iodine atoms, you can see here in the structure. Propylidone contains two iodine atoms, one ketonic group, and a propyl chain. So that's why it's called propylidone. Now, if we look upon the structure of sulfur bromoethylene sodium, it contains four bromine atoms, say 1, 2, 3, 4, and two sulfonic acid groups. Now, if we see indigotin disulfonate, first of all, it can be easily divided into two parts, and it contains this indole nucleus. You can see here also indole nucleus, and two sulfonic acid groups. Similarly, Evansville is also in two parts, converted again into equal parts. Fluorescent sodium is a anthracene type molecule. If we talk about the chemistry of propylidone, it is a propyl acetate derivative in which you can see the alpha carbon atom is replaced by iodine substituted pyridine moiety, which in addition also has ketonic group. As far as its physical properties are concerned, it is white crystalline powder that is odorless, and it is slightly soluble in water. If we talk about its chemical property, when we heat propylidone with concentrated sulfuric acid, it produces violet colored vapors of the iodine. It can be stored in the well closed light resistant containers, and it can be used as a contrast media for the purpose of bronchography. Now, iopenoic acid, as far as its chemistry is concerned, we can see it is a butyric acid derivative. See, it is a butyric acid derivative in which hydrogen atom of the carbon is replaced by iodine substituted benzyl group. As far as its physical properties are concerned, again it is a white colored powder, odorless, tasteless, and when we heat it strongly, so likewise propylidone, it also produces violet colored vapors of the iodine. Here we can consider one more property of this iopenoic acid. It undergoes diazotization and coupling reaction. Why it's happening? It is happening due to the presence of this amino group. So my dear students, remember this, why iopenoic acid is undergoing diazotization and coupling reaction? It's only due to this NH2 group. And after diazotization and coupling reaction, it gives deep orange red precipitation. Like propylidone, it can be stored in the well closed light resistant container, and it is used in the radiography of the gallbladder. Next five compounds we can summarize in the form of a table. So next five compounds, let's recall them. First of all, sulfobromothiolene sodium, indigotin disulfonate, that is also known as indigo carmine, Evans blue, convered, and fluorescein sodium. So if you see state, physical state, all of them are the solid, but they are differing in the color. Sulfobromothiolene sodium is white, indigotin disulfonate is purplish blue, Evans blue is bluish green in color, convered, as its name is indicating, it's reddish brown, and fluorescent sodium is the orange red in the color. And all the five are, if you see, they are all the five are odorless. Now if we talk about the taste, fluorescent sodium has tasteless, sulfobromothiolene sodium is bitter, and for indigotin disulfonate, Evans blue, and convered, taste is unidentified. If we look upon the solubility, sulfobromothiolene is sodium is soluble in water, Indigotin disulfonate is aspirin, soluble in water. Evesbilieu is also soluble in water. Congodate is also soluble in water. Fluorescein sodium is also soluble in water. So if we see, so among these five, only indigotin disulfonate is sparingly soluble. Otherwise, all the four are soluble in water. Now storage, if we look, so all the five can be stored under similar conditions, means stored in well closed light resistant container. Store in well closed light resistant container. Now if we talk about the uses of these five compounds, sulfur bromoethylene sodium is used to test functional capacity of liver. Indigotin disulfonate is used to test kidney function. Evesbilieu is used to test determine blood volume. Congodate to detect amyloid, deposition of the amyloid tissue. Fluorescein sodium is to detect lesions and foreign bodies, and it is used for the purpose of investigation of circulatory disorder for differentiation between normal and the malignant tissue. Here I would like to mention radiopharmaceuticals, that is radioisotope, although they are not the part of our syllabus, but I specifically mention here why. It is because they are used for the mainly for the diagnostic purposes. So as we know, radiopharmaceuticals are the radioactive compounds. They can be injected by various routes, say for example mouth, injection, eye, bladder, in small amounts. And the doses of radiopharmaceutical vary depending on the type of the test, and they are used under the direct supervision of the specialized doctor. And the unit, as you must have read in your first year course, the unit of radiopharmaceuticals are Curie and the Becquerel. So here are the few examples of the radiopharmaceuticals. For biliary tract blockage, titanium disulfenin is used. For blood volume studies, sodium chromate is used. For blood vessels disease, sodium pertactinate is used. For bone disease, sodium fluoride is used. For bone marrow disease, chromium, titanium, and sulfur colloid are used. For brain disease and tumor, indium is used. For cancer tumor, gallium citrate, gallium, sodium fluoride is also used. For heart diseases, ammonia, rubidium, and thallus chloride is used. Similarly, iodope, hippurate sodium is utilized for the kidney diseases. Ammonia and albumin colloid are used for the liver disease. And for lungs disease, krypton and xenon are used. I hope you must have understand what I want to tell you about the diagnostic agents. Thank you, students.